Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms is here to answer your plant questions. How are you today?
Very good. How are you doing?
Good. And you brought a beautiful fall-looking plant.
This is cool. This is croton, and crotons are house plants. But this time of year when people do a lot of decorating with plants, whether it's mums or pansies or whatever, this is a great plant to put outside until all danger of frost is gone. But then bring it inside, pile some like little pumpkins and gourds around it, maybe a couple mums, and it's just a fun plant.
I love the look of it. All right, here's our first question. It's from Barry. He says, what's the best way to eliminate prickly weeds from my landscaped area?
Well, if the prickly weeds are thistle, that's one of the few plants I wouldn't mind people spraying. I mean, usually I'm not all about that all the time, but if that sets seeds, they can really be a problem and are a noxious plant in this area. So you can try to dig it up by the roots, but the roots are pretty long. If you can get a hold of some weed killer, something like a Roundup, paint it right on the plant, and that should kill it all the way back, and then pull it out. I wouldn't just go spray to spray it, but if you cut that off and paint some Roundup on it, or you just take the whole plant, give it a good spray, you'll be in good shape.
Okay, sounds good. Next question is from John. Bugs keep laying eggs on our pumpkins. We use an insecticide and physically remove them, but it's not working. Is there any way to keep the bugs permanently off them?
The other way would be to grow with a grow cover, and these are floating row covers that you can put right over your plants. Mm-hmm. They still let the sunlight through, but they really do stop some bugs and stuff from laying eggs, so that is a way to go. Usually with most worms and caterpillars and stuff you get, you can use a natural insecticide called BT.
Okay.
So there are some options there.
Okay. Now this question, I'm embarrassed to say, is from me.
I love it.
I've had a Christmas tree in my garage since last year. Can I put it to good use in my garden instead of just throwing it out?
A lot of people with their used Christmas trees, let's just say, you cut off some of those branches and you can actually put it out in your garden, use it as mulch. It's also great for if you have some wild animals that you enjoy in your garden, things like bunnies and, you know, whatever. They can act as cover for them and also for birds. So, yeah, you could put it out there. Eventually, it's going to degrade. Put it in your compost pile. It might take a little bit, too.
It's already degrading.
sounds like it's not in good shape. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Nice to see you, Carrie, as always. And